Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to add and customize connectors in the Angular Diagram component. I will explain how to draw connectors using a drawing object. You will see how to customize and remove connectors and use different connector segments. First, I open an existing Angular application where I have added the diagram component with basic shapes. To learn more about integrating the diagram component into an Angular application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application using the command ng-serve. The diagram canvas is rendered with the specified shapes. Now, I am going to show you how to create a connector between the first and second nodes. I add the eConnectors tag to define the collection of connectors. To define a single connector, I add the eConnector tag. Next, set the property ID to term connector. Then, to set the source node, add the source ID property and assign the ID of the first node, terminator. Also set the target node by adding the target ID property and assign the ID of second node, process. You can see a connector added between the first and second nodes. Now, let me show you how to add a connector between process and decision nodes when a button is clicked. For that, I am going to use Syncfusion Angular button component. I install the Syncfusion Angular buttons package by running the command ng add Syncfusion ej to Angular buttons. In the app module file, see the button module imported from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular buttons package and injected into the imports array of the ng module. And add the button component by defining the ejs button attribute with the button content add connector. As I said before, I want to create a connector when a button is clicked, so I add the event click with the event handler add connector. I define the add connector method here. And declare the new connector variable. Set the properties ID to process connector. Source ID to process. And target ID to decision to create a connector. Notice this connector model class is imported from the Syncfusion ej2 Angular Diagrams package. To add the connector using the diagrams built-in method, I add the reference variable to the diagram component. And import the view child from Angular core package and create the diagram instance. Using the diagram instance, I call the add connector method and pass this new connector object. In the app component CSS file, add the margin for the button to align it. When I click the button, a new connector is added between the process and decision nodes on the canvas. Next, let's see how to add a connector using a drawing tool. I am going to activate the drawing tool with a button click. I include another button and change the click event callback method as draw connector and content as draw connector. I define the callback method here. Using the diagram object, I define the tool option to draw once, as I choose to draw only one connector. You can also set the continuous draw option to draw more than one connector at a time. Then, I need to specify the type of connector that can be drawn with the drawing tool. In this example, I am going to draw a straight connector. I define the drawing object to create a new connector with the type straight. At last, I call the DataBind method to apply these property changes to the component. I click the button to activate the drawing tool and create a connector here by drawing. Now, I add a connector for the process and decision nodes to explain other features with clarity. Next, I will show you how to customize and remove a connector from the diagram canvas. First, I will customize the connector by changing the stroke color and stroke width. To do that, I add one more button to the page and change the event handler for the click event as edit connector. I change the content as edit connector. I define the callback method in the app component TS file. In this method, I get the first connector from the connectors collection by passing an index of 0. Then I change its style by defining the stroke color to orange. And the stroke width to 3. When I click the Edit Connector button, the connector's stroke color and stroke width are changed. To remove a connector from the canvas, I add a button with the click event as Remove Connector Event Handler. And also change the content. I define the callback method here. Within the remove connector event handler, I call the remove method using the diagram instance. As I'm going to remove the first connector from the collection, I specify the index as 0. See, the first connector is removed when I click the remove connector button. Let's move on to the different types of connector segments. The Syncfusion Angular Diagram component supports 4 types of segments. They are straight, orthogonal, bezier, and polyline. So far, you saw the default segment, straight. Now, I will show you how to set the orthogonal segment type. The orthogonal segment is used to create segments that are perpendicular to each other. To do that, I add another connector with the ID as decision connector. And set the source ID as decision, and target ID as process. I add the type property, and set its value to orthogonal. To customize the segments, I add the segments property. In the app component TS file, define a new variable, segment, with the type object. As I want to display the segment in the right, I set the direction as right. Additionally, I can adjust the length of this right flow by setting it to 100 pixels. And assign this variable to the segment's property. Then to define the position of connecting ports, I declare the port variable of type object. I add the ID and appropriate offset X and Y values. Then assign this port ID to the source port ID and target port ID properties. Also, assign this port variable to the ports property of the process and decision nodes. I'll explain more about ports in my upcoming videos. Now, you can see orthogonal segments added between the specified nodes. Similarly, you can customize the Bezier type connector. Bezier segments are utilized to create curved segments, and these curves can be configured using either control points or vectors. To do that, change the connector type property to Bezier. In the app-component.ts file, define the segment type as Bezier. And appropriate x and y values for point 1 and point 2 properties. See the rendered Bezier segment. Finally, I'll show you how to add annotations to the connector. Based on the flow, I need to add annotations to the connector from decision to process nodes. So, I add the eConnectorAnnotations tag to define the annotation collection and eConnectorAnnotation tag to define a single annotation and set the content as no. Also, I define the connector style variable of type text style model and set the fill color to white. Note that text style model is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Diagrams package. Assign this variable to the style property. In the same way, I add another connector to the decision and end nodes and set the annotation content to yes. Check now, connector annotations are added with specified content. Notice that the source decorator shape is set to none, and the target decorator is set to arrow, by default. In addition to these default types, both the source and target decorators offer 10 more types such as arrow, diamond, open arrow, and so on. To change the shape of the target, I add the target decorator property, and then declare the variable decorator and define the shape to diamond and style with fill color to orange. Then assign this variable to the target decorator property of the first connector. See the decorator shape is changed to diamond for the first connector. In this video, I have shown you how to add a connector in the code behind at runtime and draw a connector using the drawing tool. You also saw how to customize and remove connectors from the diagram canvas. Lastly, I showed you the different connector segments and decorator shapes. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.